We had a Travis. We had a lot of people there. I'll be down.
We had someone yesterday just walk up and offer her services pro bono. Her name is Kim, I can't remember, but I gave a card and I gave it to someone.
So we have a card, several members.
Okay.
So later on, we can help.
We got permission to Kim.
We have permission to Kim, but we got to stretch the one half. What they told me verbatim is like anything that's hoisted up in the air to pay the covers, but we can't have anything like that.
See,
so if it rains today, all we have is this part, like, what do you call those parts? What I suggest is that we have a lot of places that have like. Even the gazebo, we could pull some of the things out and use the cards to pull the data and have it in the gazebo. I spent the night last night here. The grass is like colorful. I swear to you, I slept the most comfortable here because I knew I didn't have to pay to sleep here. I was like, yes, thank you.
The officer also mentioned that having a sleeping bag was a bad idea.
Yeah.
It would also, like, kind of camping in restaurants.
Really? I thought they said that Angel came. That's what they said last night.
Yeah.
Oh, he came yesterday. He talked to us whenever there was some marching in the Travis Square coming over here, and he said, just be careful, you know.
Yeah.
He's just, he said sleeping bags is
fine. I
don't think they can legally distinguish between a blanket and a sleeping bag. I don't think there's a legal definition for either of those.
The way that Mr. Gable de Nong told me is that the reason why those laws are in place are so people that are squatters don't like to build a makeshift house out of timber. It's like nowhere. And that's not our idea. We're just trying to keep here. We're not planning to live.
I haven't done it yet, but after this meeting's over, I'm going to call, I was given the number to Parks and Recreation headquarters, and I'm just going to get like a blanket permit to set up like, not tents, but like I've got like a pop-up sunshade I can bring, see if that's okay, if we can get a blanket permit by myself. And the officer I spoke to on the phone said that they might just grant us, a blanket permit, free of charge. They might charge us permits if they don't do that.
Is that for shade or?
Yeah, it's just for shade. I mean, if you're anything for like medical team, you don't have a shade to stand under. You don't want to be more covered.
Yeah, right.
I'm assuming a quick request, but I just have to get off. I'm going to be working tonight, so we're going to have that guy come back to me. You know, the lady lights are up. If anybody could like take some just even more basic notes. Just because I'd really like to be able to be in on that, but unfortunately, I do have to go to work. So if anybody would offer to take notes, that would be absolutely.
Yeah, we definitely need to get some notes of like the meeting and people who are on the website. I'm going to try to be here all weekend, but like tonight, I've got some information.
Another dimension that maybe we could have somebody to take notes or I know it wastes a lot of film, but maybe someone filming into the workshop so that way.
What I wanted to add is, should this be an ongoing, like, know your rights, should it be an ongoing thing so that way if you miss it today, maybe you'll be able to do it tomorrow?
Sure. Yeah, because I just barely joined the group yesterday, so if y'all had done it before that, I wouldn't have been able to have a chance. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think having a transcriber for any would be probably a good idea, so everybody knows. I guess it'd be nice to just have like one like hard copy of like, okay, this is what we do.
There is on the discussion boards on our Facebook page. There are, if you go to the legal committee, we do have the bullet points that we've talked to the national lawyers already. So we do have a lot of, like almost know your rights things that you will probably be doing, telling people that it's not a right. But there is a question there.
Yeah.
What if we just record the workshop and say it's necessary, like, you want to join in, know your rights, and it's necessary to know, like, look at this before you come on the website or anything.
There are already plenty of videos that we've posted to the Facebook page that already cover, like, the basic information that we need to know. I mean, we continue to have, like, workshops at school people who don't have the internet access.
Yeah, I just think it's important not to do that just because we want as many people as we can to be united.
Also, when you see people pointing, that doesn't mean for you to hurry up. It just means that person's back.
Oh, I understand.
Okay.